What's going on, guys? It's Greg from East Coast Dyes, and yesterday was the launch of our new mint ball, which we are crazy excited about. It went really, really well. And today is the inside the product video. So basically, I'm going to give you guys like the inside look, the breakdown at what this thing's going to do, the engineering, the testing behind it, some of the stuff you might not have gotten from our marketing materials, more of a behind the scenes look. So basically, the mint is our all new lacrosse ball. It comes in singles, six packs, and 36 pack buckets. This is what a six pack looks like. You'll see a POP display in stores for the singles, and the bucket's got 36 balls in it. So basically, to start you out with what it does, is it stays always fresh. That was the reason people asked, does it smell like mint? It does not. It smells like a normal lacrosse ball. The reason for the name mint was for people to connect it with something that was always fresh. And what we mean by that is that they're always gonna stay grippy and they're not gonna turn into greasers. And I'll get into how that happened in a little bit. The second thing is upgraded safety. So these are actually gonna notice a little softer than normal lacrosse balls. And that's how lacrosse balls should feel. They can turn into rocks, which is dangerous, causes really high impact forces. And Noxie just approved a new standard in 2017, in July, which our ball already meets, and it's one of the only ones that does. And finally, made in the USA, which is something that's really important to us. You know, it costs a little bit more, but it's important to us to create American jobs. We have them being packaged here and manufactured in the USA. And it's something we're trying to do with all of our products, and we already do with our mesh, and we will do with our head. So those are the three things that we're really excited for this ball. So now let's talk about a little bit of how we made that happen. And the main thing is new material, new manufacturing process. So it's a brand new material, completely different from other lacrosse balls, and that requires a new manufacturing process. And the reason I was asking, like, why are they so expensive? I wish they were cheaper. To be honest, we wish they were a little cheaper too, and we wish we could make them cheaper. But at this time, with this completely new material, completely new manufacturing process, and the fact that it's made in the USA, just adds a little bit of cost. So we couldn't make them as cheap as normal lacrosse balls, but they will outlast them by our research shows 5, 6, or even 7 times. You know, they stay grippy for a very long time. So you kind of get what you pay for, and they're gonna last way longer. So as long as you don't lose them, you know, we still haven't found a way to make you not lose them. They're gonna last a really, really long time. And a lot of people ask, like, how are you sure it's not gonna turn greasy? How do you know it's gonna work well? I did a couple things, on-field testing as well as lab testing. So they have weathering chambers, which can accelerate things like UV light and rain and humidity. So you can condense what would essentially be months or years of actual use into just days of testing. And they were also field tested. There were college teams that used them that were previously switching all their balls out every single week. They would get all new balls because they'd become greasy and they just don't play like game balls. They were previously switching them all out, and they tested the mint, and all the players were constantly searching for the new prototype ones because they were always more grippy. So here is a prototype mint ball. This is before they even had logos on them. We were just testing the performance of them and the new material. And this is, you know, we've been testing these, working on it for almost a year now. So this is very, very old, and it might be a little dirty. You know, we can't stop lacrosse balls from getting dirty, but it is still just as grippy, if not a little bit more grippy, than day one. And that means, you know, when you pick one up, you're not gonna sail it high. It's gonna perform just like a ball that you would pick up in the game. So it's important to differentiate. Some people see a dirty ball and they assume it's a greaser. Greasy doesn't mean dirty. Greasy means slippery. And so a ball can be dirty, like ours, and still extremely, extremely grippy. So overall, we're really excited about this innovation. Ever since I was a kid playing, this was a huge problem. My dad's bucket would always be full of greasers. I always try and like snake him out when he wasn't looking, but he never wanted me to because they were kind of expensive. But it really does help the way you train. If you train with a ball that feels the way it will in an actual game, your reps are going to count more, and you're going to make the most out of those training sessions. So we're really pumped about it. It's a big innovation for lacrosse, and we're excited for you guys to grab them, try them out, really validate, you know, that they are working. Let us know how it's working for your guys' training. So make sure you check them out in stores. One thing we're really pumped about is the bucket has our company slogan, "Hard work pays off" there. We use that all the time around here, and it's something I really believe in and have built this company on. We want to put it on there so that every time you take the bucket out, and get inspired to work a little harder and know that your work is going to be paying off. So thanks for watching, guys. Make sure to let me know what you think in the comments. If you have any questions, leave them down there. I might do a little Snapchat Q&A about the mint. Have a great weekend.